Good morning, class. How are you all? Hope all are doing fine. In the previous class, we have discussed future, simple future and future continuous tense. In this class, we'll be resuming with future perfect tense and future perfect continuous tense, right? So, what is future perfect tense? First, let us know about the structure. As we know, shall or will, that has to be there, right? So this auxiliary verb should be there in future tense. So after the subject, shall or will comes, then have, and then the past participle of the main verb and the rest part of the sentence. For example, I will have gone to school. I will, shall or will, then have, not has, only have, then the past participle of the main verb, past participle, and the rest of the sentence. Okay, so when we will use this future perfect tense, when we will talk about an action in future that takes place before another action happens. For example, Sumita will have gone to station before the train leaves. So we are talking about two actions here, right? Sumita will go and the train will leave, right? So we will talk about this tense when among these two actions, the first one will happen beforehand. Sumita will have gone to the station, and the rest part we will write in simple present tense, before the train leaves. Okay? So, how to make it negative? As we know, Sumita will not have left the station by 9 o'clock. So, will, then, not, then, have, then, the past participle. Sumita will not have left the station by 9 o'clock. They will not have burnt the village before the army arrives. They will, first will come, then will not, then the negative word. Keep in mind, after will, not, then have, then the past participle of the main verb. This is the way to make it negative. How to make it interrogative? Will Sumita have left by 9 o'clock? Will, that comes beforehand, then the subject, that is Sumita, then have, then the past participle, and then the rest part. Will Sumita have left by 9 o'clock? Question mark. So how to make it interrogative? First we will write will, then subject, then have, and then the past participle of the main verb. As you can see, the exercise is given D. I will ask all of you to have your pen and copy opened and start writing. I'm just going to help you out. By 9 o'clock, sorry, let me just read out the instruction for you first. Use the future perfect forms of the verbs in the brackets to complete the following sentences. So we are asked to use the future perfect forms of the verbs given in the bracket to complete the sentences. By 9 o'clock tonight, I dash my assignment complete within bracket, it's written. So, by 9 o'clock tonight, what is the rule? I shall or will, then have, then past participle of the main verb. What is the main verb here? That is complete, given in the bracket, right? So, by 9 o'clock tonight, I will have completed my assignment. I will have completed my assignment. Suresh, dash on leave by next week, within bracket, go is given, right? Suresh will have gone on leave by next week. Mohit, dash washing by 3 p.m., finish, within bracket. Mohit will have finished washing by 3 p.m. By 2024, we dash in Delhi for 10 years. By 2024, we will have lived in Delhi for 10 years. Nita dash a new story by this weekend. Nita will have written a story by this weekend. The players dash the stadium before the minister does. The players will have reached the stadium before the minister does. Okay? Number 7. The students dash into the van by 7 a.m. within bracket gate. The students will have got into the van by 7 a.m. The parents dash in the hall before the principal's speech begins, within bracket assemble. The parents will have assembled in the hall before the principal's speech begins. An average child dash 50,000 advertisement on TV by time he or she is 10 years old. An average child will have watched 50,000 advertisements on TV by time he or she is 10 years old. Okay? Now you are asked, rewrite the sentences in exercise D, first as negative and then as question in the future perfect tense. So you can do on your own, okay? And if you have any difficulty, the answer you will get there in the worksheet section. After doing this, you will go to the section and you will vary with your answer, okay? Because the rule is known to you, how to make it interrogative, we know that. First will comes and then the subject and then have and then the past participle of the main verb, right? You can do this. And question mark, don't forget to put the question mark at the end. Because if you forget to put that, your sentence will be considered as wrong. And how to make it negative, that is also known to you. First you will write the subject, then will, then not, after will not comes, then have, then the past participle of the main verb and then the rest. Okay, so you can do that. Now future perfect continuous tense. Future perfect continuous tense, let us first discuss about its structure. What is the structure? First will, then have, then been, then we will add ing with the main verb. Okay, so for example, we can say I will have been doing the I will have been cooking a chicken. Okay, so I, then will, then have, then been, then the main verb plus ing, then the rest. There's an easy trick. What is that? It's the tense is called future perfect continuous. So it's obvious that we will have both the structures mixed or jumbled up here. We know that what is the rule of continuous tense, that we know the verb and then we will add ing with the main verb, right? So that is here. And then, what is the rule of perfect? Perfect, we know that have or has will be added, and then the past participle form. So here in future, we know that what is the rule? First will, then have. So this will remain constant here. Will have. Okay, so we have completed the part of the perfect tense. And now comes continuous. For continuous, we will be adding been, then we will add ing. Understood? So first will, then have, then been, then ing, then we will add ing with the main verb, then the rest part of the sentence. Okay, so this is used to talk about an action in progress before up to a specific point of time in the future. So this will generally tell us about an action that will be happening in the future for a certain point of time. For example, Nayana will have been reading for 4 hours by 5 o'clock. So see, the specific time is given here by 5 o'clock. So if Nayana reads by 5 o'clock, she'll be completed 4 hours. Okay? So it is a continuation. The work is still in progress, but in future. So the specific time has to be mentioned. Next is, he will have been eating an hour in 5 minutes. He will have been eating for an hour in 5 minutes. See, the time is specified. So how to make it negative? Again, the rule is quite same. After will, we will put not, and then the rest, have been, ing, whatever. Okay, so Nayana will not have been reading for 4 hours by 5 o'clock. He will not have been eating for an hour in 5 minutes. Question, how to make this interrogative? So first we will write will, and then the subject, then have been whatever, then ing, and then the rest. Okay, so will Nayana have been reading for 4 hours by 5 o'clock? Question mark. Will he have been eating for an hour in 5 minutes? Question mark. So the next exercise comes to us. That is what? That is F. Complete the following sentences using the future perfect continuous forms of the verbs given in the brackets. So here we are asked to use the future perfect continuous form of the verbs given in the brackets. So let us begin. You please be prepared with your pen and copy. By the time the children come, we dash the house for 5 hours. So by the time the children come, we will have been cleaning. We'll have been cleaning the house for 5 hours. Shumesh dash his essay when we leave the class, within bracket, write. Shumesh will have been writing his essay when we leave the class. The rivers dash when the monsoon starts, dry up, within bracket. The rivers will have been drying up when the monsoon starts. Dash you dash when I call, meditate. Question mark. So how to make it? Will, as I say, always will come forward. So will you have been meditating when I call? Question mark. Girish dash his things when we go there. Girish will have been packing his things when we go there. Sandhya, dash at the time you get back from office, within bracket, cook. Sandhya will have been cooking at the time you get back from office. What dash you dash this time next year, within bracket, do, question mark. So it is an interrogative sentence. So what will you have been doing this time next year? How dash you dash home after the program, within bracket, go. How will you have been going home after the program? Okay, so this is done. Now we will learn some different ways, okay, to express something that will happen in future, but we will not follow the conventional way to make this sentences in future. We will avoid writing shall or will. Then also we will be making people understand that we are talking about certain happenance that will happen in future, but we'll not use the auxiliary verb shall or will. This is very interesting and these are exceptions. So you please look at your book, and it's page number 98. See the first example, present simple. The present simple is used to talk about timetables or schedules in the future. So we can use simple present tense or present simple whenever we are talking about some timetables or schedule in future. Okay, for example, the train leaves at 5:30. Not the train will leave at 5:30. This is a set timetable. The train is scheduled to go at 5:30. So we will use simple present tense here. The train leaves at 5:30. Okay? Then the new series starts on Monday. So it is already scheduled that the series will come, come on the television screen, or will be on air on Monday. So the timetable is set. We can use, or we will use, simple present tense. Next is present continuous tense. The present continuous tense is used to talk about someone's plan. See, if we are talking about someone's plan, we can use present continuous tense. But remember, we are talking about future. Then also we can use present continuous tense. Harish is visiting us tomorrow. Harish is visiting us tomorrow. Tomorrow. In future it will happen. Okay. But it is his plan. That is why we will write present continuous tense. Sunita is leaving for Delhi this evening. Sunita is leaving for Delhi this evening. That is her plan to leave for Delhi. So we will write, Sumita is leaving for Delhi this evening. Be going to. We can use be going to show something that someone intends to do. Okay? To show something that someone intends to do. Shumesh is going to write a new poem. He intends to write a new poem. So we will write here, be going to. The workers are going to start a strike. Okay? They are going to start a strike. They intend to start a strike. Now, the last exercise, that is exercise G. Use the correct present tense forms of the verbs in the brackets to express future. Okay, so we are asked to use the present tense only, but we will be speaking about things that will happen in future. So first we need to read this, the other ways of expressing future. This column has to be read by all of you first, and then you will you'll be coming to the exercise and try to solve. Okay, otherwise you cannot. So the show dash in the last week of January, within bracket open. So we can write the show opens in the last week of January, as this is scheduled already. Siddharth dash trees along the edge of his garden tomorrow, within bracket plant. So it is his plan, he is going to do that, right? So we will write Siddharth is planting trees along the edge of his garden tomorrow. Sujit dash a lecture this evening. Okay, that is also Sujit's plan. So Sujit is giving a lecture this evening. I dash John at 6 o'clock, within bracket C. So it is already scheduled. So I see John at 6 o'clock. The race dash at 4:15, within bracket begin. The race begins at 4:15. Again, this was scheduled. Anushka dash these cartons, within bracket change. So Anushka intends to do that, right? So we will write Anushka is going to change these cartons. Balbir Singh dash tonight, within bracket perform. Balbir Singh is performing tonight. The concert dash at 8 o'clock, within bracket start. The concert starts at 8 o'clock. Mr. H dash a mind show this evening, within bracket present. Mr. H is presenting a mime show this evening. I dash this old car, within bracket sell. So I intend to sell the car, right? So I am going to sell this old car. So here future tense ends. So be prepared for your revision test on tense, and we will be starting with a new chapter in the next class. But the class does not end here, because yes, I know all of you haven't practiced those writings, I mean composition and letter, for a long time, and you must be missing in writing those, right? And today, one letter, one composition I have designed for you. This is your assignment. You have to write. So let me just tell you once what is that. So I know all of you are missing your school days very badly, and all of you are really want to have them back as soon as possible. Many of you are asking me, when will the school reopen? I know, but I do not have this answer right now. Whenever it will get reopened, we all will be informed, and we all of us are looking forward to have those happy days back, right? So the letter is based on this particular subject, this topic, right? So you will be writing a letter to your friend telling him or her about how much you're missing your school days before this pandemic situation begins, and how eager you are to get them back. This is your topic. And for composition, I have given a topic, write a composition on your favorite color. Why this topic I have chosen? Because there you will write, first you will write the heading, and maintaining this three paragraphs, that is introduction, body and conclusion, you will be completing your composition, right? So why there are several colors in the world, right? And sometimes even if the color doesn't exist, we can make it using two or three or more colors and make it a unique one, right? So the composition is on your favorite color. First you will write, what is your favorite color? Why do you like the color? Why is that your favorite, and why do you like that color the most of all colors? Okay, what is the unique part of the color. Is there any story related to the color? That is why the color has become so favorite to you. So, may you know, these are the points you will include, and you will write a beautiful composition on your favorite color. These topics you will get available there in the worksheet section. And yes, you will also have your answers of unit test there in the worksheet section. So, I think this class was helpful to you. So, there are a lot of assignments waiting for you. You just go on doing that, and we'll meet in the next class. Keep on studying and take care of yourself. Take care of everyone around you. Have a great day ahead. Okay? Thank you.